Why would an American president support the freeing of the murderer of hundreds of Americans?
Now, what's amazing, before the book, The Roots of Obama's Rage, even left the warehouse, it was being attacked by those on the left and some people on the right. I'm going to leave the left out of it because they'll attack anything you do. But I want to read you a quote by Ramesh Panuru at National Review, and he said this of your premise. I think that it is a mistake to imagine that Obama is a deeply mysterious figure as opposed to a conventional liberal. He is no stranger than contemporary liberalism is. Your response?
Well, in the book, I list a lot of very strange things Obama does that conventional liberalism can't explain. And I'll give a single example. A year ago, the government of Scotland released the Lockerbie bomber who brought down the Pan Am jet over Lockerbie, Scotland, a terrorist convicted, and they sent him back to Libya. The Obama administration, true to form, protested and said, this is horrible. You're releasing a terrorist, a murderer of hundreds of Americans. But the London Times obtained a letter that Obama secretly sent to the Scottish government saying, we don't mind if you release this man as long as you keep him in Scotland. Don't send him back to Libya, keep him in Scotland, but we don't mind if you... Now, why would an American president support the freeing of the murderer of hundreds of Americans? I don't see Bill Clinton doing it. I don't see Jimmy Carter doing it. I don't see Kerry doing it. It's not part of liberal ideology. But for Obama, if I'm right, then Obama thinks that Iraq and Afghanistan are wars of colonial occupation. So the people fighting against America are anti-colonial resistors. Now, not that Obama approves of the killing of Americans, I'm not saying that, but I'm saying for him, Abdel Basset al-Megrahi, the Lockerbie bomber, is a fellow freedom fighter, a little bit like his own father, Barack Obama Sr. So this is why Obama has a measure of sympathy for the man. So the anti-colonial theory explains it, and conventional liberalism doesn't.
Dinesh, congratulations on the early success of the book, The Roots of Obama's Rage.